Hey everyone, welcome back with another session of social studies. So today we will discuss the major regions of the world. Okay, and the first one we have, that is Congo, the land of forests. All right, now many dense forests are situated close to the equator. All right, now this is because the areas near the equator, they receive plenty of sunlight and rain. So therefore, the climate of this region is wet and hot. Alright, and the forests in this region are so dense that the ground of the forest receives very little sunlight. So these kinds of forests are called equatorial forests. Alright, now in this lesson we will discuss about the an African country, that is the Democratic Republic of the Congo. Alright, through which the equator passes. Now let's begin. So first, that is the Democratic Republic of Congo. Now this country was earlier known as Zaire. Okay. So the DR of Congo was earlier known as Zaire, and its capital is Kinshasa. Alright, now this Congo, the DR of Congo, it is the third largest country in Africa. Understood? It's the third largest country in Africa, and it has a population over 82 million, and currently it's around 84 million. Okay. Now, this country, it established as an official Belgian colony in the year 1908. So, the Democratic Republic of the Congo, okay, they gained its independence in the year 1960. Understood? So, this is all about Congo. Now, if we discuss about the location and size, the Democratic Republic of Congo, or else we can call it the DR of the Congo, lies on either side of the equator. That means half of the portion in the northern hemisphere, half in the southern hemisphere. Alright, now its neighboring countries are Uganda, Rwanda, Tanzania and Burundi towards the eastern side. And in the northern side, we have Sudan and Central African Republic. And in the southern side, we have Zambia and Angola. And in the western, the Republic of Congo. Alright, now if you see the picture, the Democratic Republic of the Congo has the Zaire River. That is the Congo River. Now, it is the largest river in Africa after Nile. Alright, so Zaire River is the largest river in Africa. Nine. Now this river is also called the Highway of Central Africa. This river is called the Highway of Central Africa. Now if we discuss about the climate of Congo, the DR of the Congo experiences equatorial climate. Equatorial climate means it remains hot and wet throughout the year. Alright, now the average temperature is around 25 degrees Celsius, but during the day it rises to 35 degrees Celsius. Now another most important thing is most of the afternoons experiences heavy rainfall. So the mornings and nights are pleasant and cool. So its annual rainfall is above 200 centimeters. Understood? So that's why the climate of Congo remains hot throughout the year. So there is no such cold type of climate. Okay. Now if we talk about the vegetation that we have, that is most part of the Democratic Republic of the Congo is covered with dense forest. Alright. Now this is because of heavy rainfall and abundant sunlight. Understood? Now the trees grow very tall and they form canopies which prevent sunlight from reaching the ground. Alright, sunlight cannot penetrate properly through the dense forests. Now the forest also have thick undergrowth of grasses and small plants. So these forests, they remain green throughout the year. So they are also called evergreen forests. Okay, now if we see in the southern part of the Democratic Republic of the Congo, we have grasslands with short trees. Alright, now this part is not very hot and wet. So these grasslands here in the southern part of Congo, these are called the savannas. Okay, and which are the important trees grown here? Mahogany, ebony, redwood and rosewood. These are the important trees that are found in the forest of the deer of the Congo. Now along with all these trees, we also have rubber trees. Alright, along with rubber trees, creepers, climbers, these are also grown in these forests. Understood? So, together with all these factors, it makes very difficult for any traveler, for any person to travel through all these forests. So, as it is very dense and full of wildlife and all. Okay, so that's all we have in this session. In the next session, we will continue the second part. We'll discuss about the wildlife and economic resources and industries and the different lifestyle of the people in Congo. So till then, bye-bye.